Hello, Gavin Hoey here with another Photoshop tutorial. This week, I'm going to show you how you can create a ball of images using pictures that you've got on your hard drive. Now, we're also going to add in the nice little reflection underneath. So, let's start off. What we need to do, first of all, is to decide which images you'd like to go on your image ball. Now, I've already decided on 25 pictures, and I've gathered them together and put them in their own separate folder. So, they're only copies and not originals. Now that's great, because what we need to do now is to make a blank image and put each of those 25 pictures one by one on that blank sheet of paper. But that's going to take us all day, so I'm going to show you a nice neat little shortcut just to speed things up. Let's go to File and choose Automate Contact Sheet 2. Now Contact Sheet 2 is normally used for making contact sheets and proof sheets for professional photographers, but we can also use it in a way that perhaps it wasn't designed for, but works really well. First of all, you need to tell Contact Sheet 2 where your images are. So we've got to browse and find the folder that has the pictures that I've gathered together. Okay, there's mine. Lovely. Now you need to decide what size your document, your sheet of paper, is going to be. So I'm going to make my document 6 inches in height and 6 inches in width, with a resolution of 300 pixels per inch. Now the next step's absolutely vital. When you come down to Flatten All Layers, make sure that is unticked. No tick required in there. If it is ticked and it does flatten down, then this technique isn't going to work. Now onto the thumbnails. Now the thumbnails are the actual pictures themselves, and I'm going to untick the auto spacing, so that's blank, and make sure that the spacing is set to 0 in both the vertical and the horizontal. The number of columns, well, I'm going to keep that at 5 columns and 5 rows. That's a perfect size for this technique. And I'm also going to untick the rotate for best fit. And another thing I'm going to untick is the very last one, use caption names. Now, I don't want any captions, I don't want any text on my picture at all. Now, if you've done all that correctly, you should find that you have a perfectly square grey box for your preview. And you can just hit OK and let Contact Sheet do its thing. Now, what it's doing is making a blank sheet of paper to the size you specified, going to the folder that you specified, and getting each of those 25 pictures and shrinking them down and pasting them onto that document. Now, if you're using Photoshop CS4, you'll find Contact Sheet 2 has disappeared. It's not really gone. You need to either look on the DVD goodies folder or go to the Adobe website and download the legacy plugins and filters, because Contact Sheet 2 is something that is sadly missed in CS4, because it can get a whole bunch of pictures and put them onto a sheet of paper really, really quickly. And there it is. It's done. Okay, now what we want to do is to close up all of these little gaps. All these white areas need to disappear. But before we do that, have a look at your pictures and think about which one you like the most, which one has the most impact. Now, I quite like this one of the coloured leaves here. So I'm going to get the Move tool. I'm going to make sure I've put a tick in the Auto Select layer. And now if I click the leaves, I can move the leaves around. Now, I'm going to get rid of the one that's in the middle by dragging that out of the way. And you can see by using Auto Select Layers, we can very quickly start to move these images around and construct our image just by dragging these little pictures around like so. Now I'm just going to put all these into a nice little alignment. It's just going to take me a minute or two, so we'll just use the magic of video to speed everything up. Okay, so there we are. So we've just added the last one in like that. But you can see my 25 pictures don't quite fill the screen. I've still got lots of white areas here. Now, I could go in and find more pictures on my hard drive, but to be honest, these were the best 25 I had, I've got, well, no more to use. But it doesn't really matter too much once you get towards the edges, because our effect we're about to apply to these makes the middle images more dominant than the edges. So all we're going to do is to make copies of each of these layers and fill it around the edge. Now, to make a copy, there's another nice little shortcut. If you get the Move tool and hold the Alt key on a keyboard, that's the Option key on the Mac, you can simply click on any layer, and rather than dragging the layer, it makes a copy automatically, and you drag that instead. And that's really handy. So you can just come in here and you can click on one of these and drag and drop it down and start filling up the image with extra images. Okay, like that. Again, I'm just going to speed things up slightly so you don't have to sit and watch the boring bits happen. Okay, so let's just bring the last one down just to fill in the last little hole. There we go. Okay, so the whole screen is now completely full of images. And if we have a look at our layers, you'll see that our layers are, well, we've got loads of layers now. Each one of these individual images is its own separate layer. So I'm going to collapse all those layers down by using the layer and then flatten image, which has just dropped off the bottom of the screen. But that collapses all of the layers down to one single background layer. Now, with that background layer, we can make a selection of all of them. So I'm going to use the elliptical marquee and hold the shift key on the keyboard, start in one corner and drag down to the other. And by holding shift, I'll get a perfect circle, just like that. There we go. And now I can come up to edit and choose copy and back to edit and choose paste. And on our layers, you'll see that we now have our perfect circle layer. In fact, we can dump the background. We don't need that anymore. And we're down to our image circle. But it's a circle. It's not really a ball. So to make this look a little bit more three-dimensional, we're going to add, first of all, a filter effect. Let's come to filter and choose distort and spherize. Now, we're going to use spherize all the way up at 100%, right the way to the right-hand side. And click OK, and it does what it says. It makes the image look like a sphere. Now you can see why those middle images were so important and why the outer ones were less so, because it really makes the middle ones more dominant. But it's not really 3D. It almost works, but we need to add in some shading and light. So let's go to our layers. I'm going to hold the Control key, that's the Command key on a Mac, and click the little thumbnail so we have a selection of our circle. Now I'm going to make an empty layer. And with black as my foreground color, I'm going to go to edit and choose stroke and stroke it 100 pixels on the inside. So I put a thick black line around the inside of the image. But that's obviously a bit heavy. So we'll go to filter, blur and Gaussian blur. Okay, lots and lots of Gaussian blur just to blur that line out and put some shadow around the outside of our ball like that. So that gives the impression that the edges are darker and adds to the 3D feel. But to really finish that 3D feel, I'm going to get white as my foreground colour, get a little paintbrush and just put a little spectral highlight just there, a little glow like that. And then go back to the layer. Don't choose flatten image, whatever you do. Choose merge down, which is just again, just off the edge of the screen. But there we go. So that merges those two layers down, but keeps the transparency that we'll need for the next step. Okay, we can get rid of the selection, select and deselect. And we can add that picture to a new background that I've got prepared. Let me just open it up for you. There we go. There's the background. And all I need to do now is to get the move tool and click on the ball of images that we've made and drag it over and drop it onto the background. I can close that one down. I don't need it now. Lovely, there we go. So there's the image floating around. And of course, because we've dragged and dropped, we've made it a layer automatically. And we can now take that layer and make a copy of it. So we have two identical layers. And working on the bottom layer, we'll click that to make it active. We'll go to Edit, Transform, and we'll rotate it, we'll flip it vertically. Okay, now nothing seems to change because it's absolutely underneath the top layer, but there it is. You can see that the one we've now got is flipped over. And if I get the move tool, if I untick auto select layers, because that tends to give us a few problems if we don't, I can now drag this down like so. I'm going to hold the shift key so it goes in a nice straight line until it's almost touching the bottom, but not quite. So round about there somewhere. To make it look more like a reflection, I'm just going to drop the opacity of that layer down a wee bit. So we'll drop the opacity down to around about 50-60%, somewhere in that area. Okay. And finally, to really make it look more like a reflection, I'm just going to get the eraser tool with a big eraser brush. You could use a layer mask if you prefer, but for speed, I'm just going to run the eraser just along the bottom, just like that. And we now have a nice little reflection in there as well. Okay, so there we are. And there's how you can create your very own 3D ball of images inside of Photoshop.